Okay, my name is Michel Bequin, and this is the outline of my presentation. After a brief introduction to Buildbot infrastructure, I will show you the evolution of the test farm since the last workshop in Louvain-la-Neuve. Then I will present an overview of Buildbot portal, and I will discuss the upgrade of infrastructure. And finally, if there is still time, I will make a small live visit of BB Portal. The good question is how to maintain core integrity despite numerous modifications, including bug insertion. Basically, by applying the principle of continuous integration, CI. The main focus of CI is to prevent integration problems. To achieve that, it's relied on the following principle: maintaining of code repository with a version control system like Git for Ambinet, daily removing and at least weekly merging of contributions, using an extensive test suite for reliability and portability, and finally, automating the build and the test with the computer test farm. You see here the workflow of this CI. For the automation of the automation part, we choose Buildbot, a powerful Python framework. It mainly consists of a build master and build slaves and builders. The build master is the central point of control and shares the configuration. It makes all decisions about what, when, and how to build. The builders is associated to a build slave. They are in charge of performing sequence of action, build step, related to building software like checkout, configure, make, run test, and so on. During the build cycle, status information is saved in the database, and we use this data to update the state of the BB portal and the status of results. When the task is complete, there are also the possibility to send an email, and we can also see the result in the waterfall. It's a special web status. When a merge request made by a developer is submitted to GitLab, the build starts automatically and executes all the tests. The developer have also the possibility to start job on demand via a form on the portal. In case of problem, the developer can access to the slave directly by SSH for debugging in case of problem, and is directly in the good correct environment. Current state of the test farm. You see here the slave matrix. There are 10 servers. We installed two new servers last year. These servers are characterized by the high number of cores. ILPS have 40 core and 80 threads, and Scope have 64 core and then 128 threads. You can notice the presence of an apple to check the test suite. You have also a slave with three GPU cards. And you can notice also that we remove IBM and IBM 8 and the two Kronos server. ABREF, before ABREF is the reference slave, now we switch to ALPS as a reference. This is the first part of a list of builders. Each builder is associated to a slave. The name of the builders is based off with four fields. The first field is the slave name. After that is the vendor version of compiler. You see here the same information. And the last field is the feature or an optional field to identify the builders. You see here a list of different numerical library tested. Here the different version of MPI stack, and here the miscellaneous feature for the different builders. For example, we have two builders checking with OpenMP. We have one builders to check CUDA framework. You have builders checking the memory leaks and so on. This builder is now the reference builder, and the result is compared with this bot. You can find more detail in the wiki concerning these different features of the builders. The debug builders is a special builder. He make a mini service. It's in charge of checking many features which are not tested on your other builder. We can mention checking the respect of the coding rule, checking the generation of doc, checking the consistency of build system, and finding the broken links in the documentation. This set of builders, depuis Vouvran and this, is called Nightly, it's a group Nightly, for the tested contribution to be integrated into Trunk. All tests in this group within Nightly builders must be successful. There are still some extra builders. We are no part of the Nightly group. These first two builders are usually used by Trunk user when creating a new release of Abinit. This builder cove generate the coverage, the code coverage, and this special builders execute tutoparal with the 64 cores. There are two following builders are not yet fully functional. Some tests fail yet. This builder tests the new Intel compiler one API. Is free. And you can use the Intel version of API for free. And this stack is widely used on HPC clusters. It compiles the code with the ELPA and Scalapack libraries. The last one is a test the integration of Trix in Abin. Little remark, we don't support anymore GNU less than version 5 and IBM XLR compiler. Now I'll tell you about the BuildBot portal. This portal has been developed mainly using AngularJS framework. There is a Mongo database, which is filled by Python script. They interact with GitLab and with BuildMaster. This portal offers three useful pages. The first one is the history of the test result obtained on builders. The second one is the on-demand form that allows you to launch the test. And the third is history of merge requests. Here is the status page. A view of the last result obtained on the builders. Here the list of builders, and here the branch testes. You see here the status of the result of the builders the software. You see here the different state of boxes. And on boxes, you see an anchor. There is a link to the old step used to construct the build. You see here all the step. For example, the checkout, the make. You see here configure with all lock and some information. You see here the compilation. You hear all the test, all the results of the test. The second page of the portal is the on-demand form. Thanks of this. These pages, we can select a branch and a builder to make a test. You see here for the branches, you select the user. You see here the available branches. You can also choose a commit if you want. After that, you select the builder. There are some, you speak about the nightly group. The nightly group say all the builders. With manual, we can choose in the list of builders and of slaves, sorry. And after that, you can choose the one builders available on this slave. When you have choose everything, you can start the builder, and you obtain the result in the DB portal status. The last page on the DB portal is the merge request history. You see here the ID of the merge. You hear the source and some information. Like the SHA, you have the target, it's mainly trunk develop, the title, and the status of the merge, merge it, close it, or open. You see here this ID of the merge. There is a link on it, and you can directly have a view of the merge in the coming from GitLab. Okay, now I will tell you about the upgrading of the infrastructure. We planned two major tasks in the next future due to the end of life of some component. I need to update BuildBot and BB portal. You see here the two component with the status of end of life. Then we are already started this, some task. The new server is already configured. GitLab is already installed. We have during the switchover, the repository will be migrated directly on the new instance of GitLab. I already tested it, it's relatively easy. Concerning the buildbot, we must upgrade to version 3 because the support is only Python 3. But many local developments are be writing with buildbot 0.8, and it's not suitable for this new version. And I need to redesign a lot of configuration, and it's not easy. Concerning the BB portal part, we are also confronted with the end of life of AngularJS. The new Angular is not compatible with the AngularJS. Therefore, it will be important to evaluate some recent JavaScript framework like Node, Vue, React, and so on before deciding to switch to Angular because it's not so easy. Perhaps we can also maybe move to Python frameworks like Flask or Django. On the other hand, buildbot version 3 offers a basic user interface, better than the previous one, but less complete than the current BB portal. The evaluation of different web technologies is still in progress. In the meantime, the current server is no longer under warranty. It's 5 years old. Then it's urgent to migrate the service to the new server, even if it means keeping the end-of-line version. In terms of security, Buildbot and BB Portal are not publicly exposed on the internet. We need authentication. Then I think it's not an issue. Okay, I don't know time.
We are a bit short. Maybe just time for a question. Okay. Or a last slide, let's say.
Okay, thank you for your attention.
Great. So I think that, thank you very much. I think that there is a question from Felix on the chat, which is that he was always wondering why use a custom-made test farm with complicated portal when GitLab is shipped with CI test capabilities. Why not use GitLab's tools instead?
Yes. the configuration of builders is not. I don't know if it's possible with GitLab CI make the same thing. The same thing with the builder we create. I know it's a good question. I try some tests with the GitLab runner, but it's less versatile than the solution the today solution. Then perhaps we can see with more detail with some specialist of GitLab Runner, but I don't know. Sorry,